When I was young and had no sense, I crawled through a hole in the backyard fence. I crawled right through and there I spied the same size hole on the other side. I called my ma, I called my pa. They said, my gosh, how brave you are, 'cause they could see when they took one look that hole was made by the gobbledygook. Now the gobbledygook is a rare old bird. He's never seen, but he's always heard. He listens to you speak and then he says the same thing back again. He listens by night, he listens by day. It doesn't matter what you say. He writes it down in a little book and reads it back in gobbledygook. So be careful, son, my daddy said, 'cause they've got a bounty on his head. You catch him live and what'll they do? They'll give you a cage in the county zoo. They'll give you silver, give you gold, give you hair when you grow bald. So I decided by hook or crook that I would capture the gobbledygook. So I took my popgun and my sling, my old hound dog and everything, and crept along the garden wall, imitating his mating call. I whispered high, I whispered low, with a hayfoot, strawfoot, dozy-do. And suddenly from his secret nook, the answer came from the gobbledygook. Fly with a bang, 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 and the echo roared and the welkin rang. When I came to, I'm proud to tell that hole was gone and the fence as well. And high and low and in between, we couldn't find a smithereen. No matter where we tried to look, there was nothing left of that gobbledygook. But sometimes now, so I've been told, when the moon is high and the wind is cold, just listen close and you will hear the gobbledygook still prowling near. I call him high, I call him low, with a hayfoot, strawfoot, dozy-do. And sometimes from his secret nook, he answers me in gobbledygook.